So today I'm just going to talk about journeying into spiritual maturity. The word of God is very clear. God wants us to move forward. God wants us to press forward. He wants us to grow up in Him. Coming to the spiritual things in God, the goal that God has set for us in His word is to become like Jesus. So spiritual maturity is aiming to become more and more like Jesus. So conformed to the image of the Son Jesus. You know, in what manner are we to be conformed to the image of the Son of God? Well, in the love that we have, that we carry, we can be conformed to the image of the Son of God. So this is the goal of our spiritual maturity, to become more like Jesus, to be complete in Him. The Word of God teaches us that spiritual maturity is very, very important to God. The Word of God is very clear that God is also moving us forward, and He wants us to keep graduating. You know how in school these days you also have kindergarten graduations, right? So, but it's good to graduate, keep graduating, keep going higher, and keep growing in God, keep learning, and you know, keep increasing in Him. So we need to move on to deeper truths in God. I want to talk about some of the traits of spiritual maturity that you and I can be aiming for. The first trait of spiritual maturity is a God-centered life. So what happens when somebody is maturing in the Lord Jesus Christ? Our life becomes a God-centered life. The second sign of spiritual maturity, or a trait of spiritual maturity, is depth in the Word of God. When we go deeper in the Word, and by that, you know, again, don't simply mean just study, but, you know, that Word enlightens us. That Word becomes a revelation. That Word, you know, strengthens us. The authority of the Word of God is building up our lives. And in that manner, we're just going deeper and deeper in the Word of God. The third character, or the third trait, would be godly character. In character, there are several things that I can talk about, but I'm just going to enlist some of these to us. When we have godly character, we are demonstrating Christ-likeness. We become selfless and God-focused. We are able to walk in love. Now, the Word of God says, put on love, which is the bond of perfection. The next trait of spiritual maturity is nurturing others. So these are the four traits that I wanted to put before us. And very quickly, I'm just going to talk about spiritual immaturity. Okay, so spiritual maturity, we've looked at it. But what is the cost of spiritual immaturity? The Bible tells us that when we are spiritually immature, what happens? We are dull of hearing. Though we hear God's word, it's not able to do its full work in our lives because we don't receive an understanding for what God is actually trying to communicate. Spiritual immaturity can cause stunting, lack of strength, the lack of stability in our spiritual lives. You know, that is spiritual immaturity, and we have to move away from that and grow up in God. So I'm quickly going to touch upon what are some things that you and I can do, and then we'll close for this morning. Some things that we can do to grow up in God. So just five things, I'll put it before us. The first one is to grow in the Word of God. If we miss out on the Word of God, we cannot expect any form of progress. So when we devote ourselves to the Word of God, we have the promise from Scripture which says that the Word of God will build you up. We can grow in our faith, so we can grow, we can keep going to the next level in our faith. That is one area that we can also focus on, and that will bring definite growth. We can grow in the grace and the knowledge of God. So as we know more about God, you know, can Jesus did that. So when I have that revelation, I know, hey, He can do that for me. He can do that for somebody else. So grow in the grace and the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. And that will propel us forward. Grow in godly character. And of course, when we talked about nurturing others, so growing in service. Growing in service. If we can pray and plan towards all of these things, I'm sure God will strengthen us and we will experience definite growth in our journey with the Lord Jesus Christ.